I'm still here, open air, beautiful skies, hungry tummy, and I can't wait to share with you my new discoveries.
Grabe ang sarap nito.
Winner. Just make sure you have your face mask, your face shield, and your alcohol, and we're all ready to go.
Sumptuous Subic. It's still a wonder to me why I never took the chance to explore its many food offerings all these years. I guess food was just one of those things I took for granted here on my way to the duty-free shops. Well, I'm just glad I'm here now, in a brand new era of travel.
I've missed seeing, hearing, and meeting the many colorful wonders of the Philippines, and I'm going to try to make every moment of this milestone FoodPrints road trip count. Siraan na naman ang diet? Aba, game na!
So my mission this morning is to enjoy the best breakfast Subic has to offer, and Gourmet Garage came highly recommended. After the necessary safety protocols, I was met by Executive Chef Buj Supe, who then gives me the 25-cent tour of this 10-year-old grocer slash cafe.
So this is our merchandise.
Yeah.
This is the deli shop.
Who chooses this merchandise?
It's Ma'am Menshu and her daughter, Ma'am Marika.
Mga mahilig kumain, ano?
Yes, they choose it themselves talaga.
Yeah.
The Ma'am Menshu, Chef Buj mentioned, is Menshu Tantoco Lopez, the gourmand who operated iconic restaurants such as Bon Appetit and the Yum Yum Tree back in the day, and now the local franchise of a huge international coffee chain. If she's behind the Gourmet Garage, then you can expect a carefully curated selection of only the best premium food products to be on these shelves.
We have gourmet products that's hard to find. The family actually goes to the abroad talaga, and really, they choose it themselves. Then they bring it here in the Philippines, then they send it here.
He's right about that. Everything from premium salt and seasonings to top brand frozen goods like foie gras and steak are here.
Ito yung quality ng marbling niya, oh. Grabe, oh. Look at that, oh. Pabili ako nito, please.
By offering such high-caliber products, Gourmet Garage built a loyal customer base of discerning foodies here in Subic. But something also happened that they didn't quite expect.
When people started to buy the steaks, the pastas, and the couple of cheeses, some of them requested if they can have it cooked, if they can have it prepare a sandwich. So then Ma'am Menshu decided to put a small kitchen then. So whatever you see in the gourmet store, you can actually have it cooked here. It's very small, it's very compact, but very efficient. Just enough to meet the demand of the diners, yes.
It's the creativity of these Filipino chefs that manages to turn any imported ingredient here into a work of art.
Our menu is actually very eclectic. We don't really carry a particular cuisine. It's a little bit of everything. Whatever we think is good, then we serve it. We cook it, whatever I think, whatever I feel like cooking, just put it on the menu, then just cook it lang.
I can't wait to try the food here. A very exciting breakfast in Subic is coming your way when FoodPrints return.
Sarap nito, men.
You know, this is going to be the first meal that I'll have in this episode, and I'll tell you why I'm kind of excited. I know the owners of this place, and as you walk into their deli, you see the display of different kinds of food. You know that these people know how to eat. What does that mean? That means that knowledge about food and the love for food will translate into their restaurant. Just by the presentation alone, I don't even have to taste this. I know that all of these are going to be very, very good. And if you can find the word more than excited, that's the vragadubidila. That's the one. I'm actually willing to try anything that comes out of the Gourmet Garage kitchen. And the chef brought out a lot, starting with a few of their bento breakfast sets. The first breakfast is going to be a bangus sardines, which means that the bangus is going to be, I don't know, pressure cooked or simmered for a long time, such that if this has bones, the tinik becomes edible. Look at this. So it's nice and tender. I think this is the bangus belly. Okay. Perfectly done. Paired with fried egg and their tomato salsa, this bangus belly sent me to heaven. Who knew the humble Pinoy bangus breakfast would be elevated like this? And you know what? I was correct. This dish, this breakfast, is exceptional. I have never experienced or come across any kind of breakfast like this. Talagang it's way up there. So good. Next is flaked Macau dried fish, which Chef Buj turns into a distinctly Pinoy breakfast set.
Ayun, parang daing.
A little bit strong, kind of salty, nice balance with the perfectly cooked scrambled eggs and the fried rice.
Yun na naman. The sweetness of the vinaigrette, onions, tomatoes. Ang sarap niya. You know, the chef better hide. I'm gonna kiss him. Ang sarap nito.
The king of Pinoy breakfasts here is their signature marinated beef tapa served with garlic rice, scrambled eggs, a fruit cup, and a green papaya relish. A big step up from our usual tapsilog, but every bit as comforting.
A little bit sweet, a little bit spicy, a little salty. Alam mo, I'm gonna travel 2-3 hours just to come here. Ganun kasarap yung food. Very, very, very good. I love it. I just simply love it.
Well, why stop now, right? How about crowd favorites from your main dishes, Chef Buj?
Our curry here is one of the best sellers. A lot of foreigners like it because a lot of British likes it actually because it's curry, but it's not really in-your-face curry. So it has that hint lang of a curry, but really more on the cumin and the cinnamon, something, and we'll serve it with the basmati rice as well.
Let me just try it on its own.
Ang lambot ng lamb. Oh my.
The flavored basmati rice is kind of loose. A fantastic combination of the basmati rice and the lamb. Have it plain with the garlic sauce or the spicy sauce, and it's still going to be delicious.
Sarap nito, men. Manghang.
Best meal so far. And for the grand finale,
Salmon raclette. Oh, wow. Look at this, huh? How will somebody think of this? There's a candle underneath that keeps the raclette warm, because if it doesn't keep warm, it's gonna harden. So, look at that. Ganda ng presentation niya. Oh my gosh, ang galing nito. Look at the raclette cheese. Oh my gosh. Mmm. And it's still hot. Ang sarap ng raclette cheese. With mushrooms and asparagus and green rice. Mmm. Winner also.
Winner.
You know, every dish that I had, I thought of my loved ones. I'm gonna bring them here. I've never tried anything like this or close to it. I mean, the level and the standard of their food is just exceptional, really. Mm.
Trust me, foodies will have the time of their lives here at Gourmet Garage Subic, absolutely.
Like they say here in Subic, it's more fantastic. Pero ang sarap talaga.
Tay bagong anyone? I better work up an appetite fast, because there's more food coming our way. See you after the break.
We know.
Subic has always been an ideal vacation spot for visitors coming from big cities. It's near enough to Manila to be accessible on a day trip, and it's got something for everyone. From eco experiences down to unique food adventures. For a lot of people, it is also the ideal place to live in during these challenging times.
This is a different place, as if you are in Singapore, you're in Hawaii. When you're inside, even if you go to the houses up there, you know, up the hill, it's because we have more trees, kahit may COVID, parang this is the place to relax. Because still fresh air, right? It's not really that congested, especially if you are in the residential areas. This is a big area, and not all are inhabited. Right? So, you are always secluded.
Rose Baldeo not only lives in Subic, she also runs the most beautiful boutique hotel in town. And within these luxury accommodations is her pet project, the Thai-themed Asian Spice Restaurant.
So far, we're the only Thai restaurant here in Subic, but there are some other restaurants who serve also binagoongan. But of course, I love my own. My binagoongan is different. Our ingredients are really made in Thailand, and we grow some of the herbs at the back of our hotels, like, well, lemongrass are fresh from our garden, the pandan. You know, we have all six small bahay kubo at the back, and we have nursery over there, which I'm going to start, you know, putting all these herbs.
So this is where I'm having my lunch. It's tasting time, or should I say, tasting time.
Ito na, my favorite part.
For starters, they brought out their roti canai, an Indian-inspired flatbread popular in Asia that they serve with a special sauce.
Mmm, okay. Ayan na. You know, you can tell from the texture that it's perfectly cooked. Okay, it's soft. A little bit chewy. That's good. That's very good. Very well made roti. There's crunch, there's chewiness, there's toast from the char. The sauce is a little bit sweet, it's a little bit, may pagka-curry ng konti, but very, very good.
So far, so good.
Winner.
What's next?
Anako, tom yam ito. What is this?
Sir? This is Tom Yam Goong Soup.
Ooh. Ayan, okay. It's very red. Looks like it's going to be very spicy.
Ooh.
Okay na yan. Thank you. I just want to taste the soup. Okay. Hmm. Yung kafir, you can smell the kafir leaf, the lemongrass, and here, ay, yung aroma of the, ano, pagka-sourness, na, you can smell it.
Does it taste as good as it smells? Let's find out.
Oh, wow. This one, I know they've adjusted the taste of this. It's not so spicy, but it's the same authentic taste of Tom Yam Goong. Okay, kasi a lot of Filipinos kasi parang they don't like spicy too much. But yung Thai talaga, spicy pero tunay ang lasa niya. Wow, sarap. Ang sarap niya. Ooh.
Rose is particularly proud of their pork binagoongan, which she says is unique to all other binagoongans.
You know what I like about their binagoongan pork? On the side, while it's still hot, there is floating oil. Naku. Sarap yan. Tapos you have sili, which I will get. Okay. Look at that. Oh. So, you cannot see the bagoong. Okay. But the pork is tender and it's toasted. Okay. And let's see. Now, this is a very well-made binagoongan. Very well-made binagoongan. Sarap. Masarap siya. It's pretty good. Actually, very good.
They've saved the best for last. I can't wait to try Rose's favorite, their signature bagoong rice.
Naku, ito na.
Powerful coffee. Wow. Bagoong rice.
Wow. Okay, let's see. Let's see. Combination fried egg. Okay. Yung sweet pork and mango. Okay. Let me try the rice muna. Okay, before I mix this, let me try the rice. Okay. The bagoong is not your local alamang. Correct me if I'm wrong, this is ano, Thai bagoong. Tama ba? Diba? Yun lang. Sarap. Comparable to the ones you find in Bangkok. I love the bagoong. Sarap.
For Subic visitors who want to indulge in Thai food suited to the Filipino palate, give this place a try.
I like being surprised with something so unexpected and good. So, I love their bagoong fried rice. This is something I'd like to have actually on its own. I can eat this eh. May ulam ka na eh, di ba? Very good.
My sumptuous Subic sojourn is almost done, but it ain't over till I take you to my favorite ribs joint in town.
Grabe, ang sarap nito.
After 2 days of non-stop eating, it's now obvious to me that Subic's food scene is exciting, vibrant, and oh so satisfying.
Every time I come here, I cannot not pass by this place. I wanted to share with you what kind of dining experience I have here every time I come to Subic. Watch!
Welcome to Texas Joe's House of Ribs, my go-to place for the best and most authentic American ribs in the Philippines.
Texas Joe's is American cuisine featuring Tex-Mex, USDA steaks, and our signature item, which is our hickory smoked ribs. We smoke our ribs, we smoke our brisket, I do a smoked Boston butt, which is a pork shoulder, and I smoke the chicken. Everything is original recipe. Sauces, the food, and everything else you can think of.
This huge 300-seater American smokehouse has been feeding Subic-based expats and travelers authentic hickory-smoked barbecue since 2010. The ribs are seriously good, and I like to enjoy them with a couple of other items on the side. These are the ones that I always order. I tell myself, you have to try something different. But when I'm here, I order the same thing, okay? Onion loaf.
Well, the onion loaf is onions, chopped, and then breaded. And then you have to cure it for up to 6 hours. And then once we start to prepare it, then we flour it again, and then we pack it into a basket. And then it's deep fried for X amount of minutes, and then served piping hot.
These are, I guess they put it in a basket and form it into this, I love onion rings, okay? Good, but let me put some ketchup. Mmm, I love their onion loaf. I like to get the outer side, and then there's the sweetness from the ketchup. Mmm. Their smoked chicken tacos are another favorite.
And then the chicken is actually the smoked chicken that I have, and we just shred it. And then we just chop up a little bit of greens, and I put in my homemade guacamole, and my pico de gallo, which is also homemade, fresh tomatoes, and the jalapenos, and the onion is all made fresh.
It's spicy, it's smoked, it's delicious.
But the star of the show here is truly the prime U.S. baby back ribs.
The ribs come from the U.S. and it comes in a big 2.5 kilo slab. And then we rub it with our special homemade rub, and then we stick it in the oven, the smoker, for about 3 hours. And then they come out and it's ready to go on the broiler and then be served to the guests.
You know, every time I come here, they're the same. The ribs are the same, okay? Show you. It's not too full of the bone, but it's tender. Mmm. Mm. It's succulent. It's outstanding. It clings to the bone, but when you bite into it, it releases. You can choose your side dishes, and I prefer to have my ribs with their homemade cornbread and gravy and mashed potatoes. There are also three sauces to choose from. Original, California honey, and my favorite, the habanero sauce.
Best ribs in Subic and Manila, easily. Grabe ang sarap nito.
The smoky flavor will make you crave dessert. And luckily, they have the best carrot cake I've ever had.
This, to me, is a recent discovery. I love carrot cake, you know, but there are many carrot cakes all over. A lot of people make this. But this one, among every carrot cake I've tried, this one stands out. Look at that. Mmm. It's moist, not too sweet. It's nutty. The cream cheese filling on top is very, very good. Ang sarap niya. Mmm. This is a very well-made carrot cake. Best I've ever had.
Speaking of the best, so far, Subic is the best trip I've taken since the lockdown. A delightful variety of cuisines, that warm Filipino hospitality, plus an up-close and personal view of the exquisite, fantastic Subic Bay? The Philippines really has so much to offer, and I'm just grateful I'm here to experience it.
If there's one good thing to come out of our current challenges, it's this. I bet nobody will ever take travel for granted again. It's indeed a luxury not many have, and we must always, always be thankful for each moment we spend out here.
What a wonderful way to end this Subic experience. You know, most everything that I tried this time, I have never experienced before. And it was such an adventure to me. I found new food, delicious, exciting. And, you know, I somehow kind of missed that. You know, over a year of experiencing the lockdown, now I experience freedom. You know what? Don't worry, we're all gonna get there.
And in the meantime, let's all just keep on trucking. Life goes on. Good food is just a safe and enjoyable road trip away. See you again on FoodPrints.